Okay, let's do old Rat Boy here now. This should be pretty easy to get square. I'm gonna go just a skosh more. Center it up a little bit. Extra coarse. And it's very nice to be able to sharpen. When I first started sharpening, I used WD-40. And oil makes no sense as a cutting fluid because oil creates a sliding space. And what you want to do is you want to reduce any sliding space, and you want to bring that knife down to that diamond in it, as close as possible. And the cutting fluid is for flushing the chips away, flushing the waste away. So oil is the worst cutting fluid you can use, but I see people use it all the time, and I've never understood it. Oil creates a sliding space. That's why you put it in your engine, because it creates a space between moving friction parts that have friction. So why would you think it would work between two pieces of metal? Look at that. Look at that. Just a couple passes and it just got it. There's just this hollow spot right here, but it got it from the back all the way to the front, except for that hollow spot right there that we're going to get rid of. That's just from, you know, remember this one was ground on the belt sander. Let's see how quickly we can get rid of that guy. Hollow spot. Oh no, no, I'm absolutely wrong. Look at this, is the bright spot that we're creating off the stone. This around here is what was left from the belt sander. So I'm pretty close. I think I'm going to just stick with that. You know, since that was just free-handed on the belt sander, I can't expect it to be, you know, too perfect. But I got this extra coarse going here, so we should be able to hoss this down. Or as I like to say, we're country muling it right now. Okay, I got it all the way back here to the back. And I got some work to do to bring it up to the front. I'm gonna do a couple more passes and see how quickly that is, because that could be, it's hard to tell with those reflections how out of flat it really is. No, I can't resist. I don't want to grind that much metal. I'm gonna make one little adjustment here. One little tiny adjustment. I'm gonna put a little mark on my knife, on my jig here. Look at that, and see, now you can see the two overlapping facets. So I tilted it, I changed the angle and made it a little steeper. I made it a little steeper. So now I'm almost to the very front here, and I can still see where that original facet and my new facet are barely overlapping. So let me just country mule this a little bit. So I'm still here on extra coarse, and I've almost got it completely straightened out. And let me see if I can give you a good shot at that bevel. Oh yeah, look at that, that looks good. There's just like one little spot right up here on the corner, and I can see where my two bevels are starting to overlap from where I changed the angle of the jig. But I think I'm gonna go with this, and oh, I've already got a burr on the back, which is good. But I'm gonna work this a little bit till I have this as one clean facet. Make sure I get that corner cleaned off. And but I changed the camera angle here so maybe you can see, get a little bit different perspective. So back here, I got my hand on the back, holding that heel down. I got one little tiny spot up here on the corner that I'm gonna get. So it's on this left side now. So I got my fine stone here. Can you see that? Course. See, holding that heel down, holding the heel of this jig down, and just going back and forth. Man, it's the technique for getting a sharp edge. Got a nice burr on the front. Back to the fine. Yeah, that piece of wire, I can see. Can you see it on my fingertip here? I can see it. It's broken into about 7 or 8 pieces right here. That little burr piece of wire off the front. So you'd be tempted to get a putty knife, something that was a little bit more rigid, but please don't do it because you can damage, you can create a little damaged edge here with that steel of that putty knife, and then as your knife goes across the edge of the stone, you can damage the beautiful edge that you're creating. So always do your lifting out of your little cutout with a wooden stick. So now we're back into the fine. Now I'm gonna set the coarse, extra coarse aside. And the higher grits I go, I do more side to side and less up and down. Very little burr. That means I'm getting a good flat facet mating that front. Little bitty one. That's okay though. We're doing good. It's gonna be a fine edge on that tool. I looked at Home Depot at chisels to try to figure out what kind this was, and I think this is a Buck Brothers chisel. They had an older version of a Buck Brothers chisel. They had some newer ones there that were quite the value. They also had some Marples chisels that looked really nice too. They had a 4-pack set for about $30 that was really good looking. Extra fine. I'm gonna hit that burr one more time and I'm gonna call it good. All right, that's one sharp chisel now. I mean, we took that thing from just a woodworker's worst embarrassment to a chisel that will do some very, very fine work now. And I feel 100% confident, and I'm gonna use it in my work.